Last week, 5 people, including Noah Lugya, Miri Naluwenda, Harriet Nachiguli, Joseph Nakabale, and Ezra Mayanja, were arraigned before Mwanga 2 Magistrate Court and charged with murder. Police say they have now intensified the hunt for one Lugya Bosataula, who is said to have hired the killers and masterminded the murder plot.
We are still continuing to receive information from the public. You remember we came up with a reward of about 10 million shillings. We've had people who have rung us and provided information, but the information has not been credible. Now we want to generate more interest in the public for them to gain also interest in this information. There could still be people out there with information regarding the whereabouts of the prime suspect and mastermind of the murder.
Police had earlier placed a 10 million shillings bounty on any information leading to Lugya's arrest. However, this did not yield any positive results. Now they have decided to double the bounty to 20 million shillings, hoping that it will attract more Ugandans to join the hunt for Lugya.
The sources obtained so far from the public have not yielded fruit. We also want to urge the suspect who is in hiding to turn himself in and defend himself. The longer he stays in hiding, the more guilty and desperate he becomes, and this could lead him into committing other crimes while aiding his escape or hideout.
Engineer Bosa was shot dead in his car on February 25, 2024, as he approached his home in Lunguja, Ruaga Division, Kampala District. Meanwhile, the Uganda police have expressed concern over the increasing cases of border border robbery and murder of border border riders. Last week, a total of 8 incidents of border border robberies were recorded, and in these, 4 people were killed.
4 motorcycles were robbed. We rescued 4, and that is the summary. But I want to caution border border riders because their safety on various stages and routes is a top priority, and despite the recent spike that we got last week, border thefts and robberies had generally declined because we had arrested most of the gang members actively involved in the murders of border border riders and theft.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, a total of 81 people died and over 300 were seriously injured in road crashes last week. The crashes are attributed to reckless road usage by especially the motorcyclists. Traffic Police spokesperson Michael Kananura also revealed that they are launching a number of operations to ensure that sanity is restored on the road.
All drivers and riders who do not possess valid driving licenses, please don't risk to use these roads.
From the Uganda Railway Corporation, management has expressed concern over the continued misuse of a newly reconstructed Kampala railway line, which has led to increased accidents on the line. David Musokerubega, the URC managing director, says in the previous weeks they have registered a number of accidents along the railway line.
We appeal to the market vendors right from Chireka, from Namave, Chireku, Chireka, who are fond of spreading merchandise on the railway line. Not only that, we are having Ugandans dumping garbage on the railway line. This is very dangerous to our operations. So we request that people stop dumping garbage, especially this is around the Nambole area.
The newly reconstructed railway line will resume full operations at the end of this month after close to a year of overhauls. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.